My name's Tom Kroski. I'm here at the Crow River in Delano, Minnesota. I've volunteered, spoke with Joe McDonald, the mayor, and asked if I could help, and he suggested that I walk the dikes and see if we have any problem areas. Right now, things seem to be holding up rather well. There is one area that would be the likely area for a breach about 100 meters north of the Highway 12 bridge. Other than that, I've seen no seepage on the levees, and now I've just done about half of the west side of the river here. It appears, from what I'm hearing, that we've coming close to a crest. I suppose the big issue right now would be is if we got some debris that got hung up on the bridge here. This bridge is not a single span, it's got two piers. If you get a big cottonwood that might come up against that could be a big problem. But otherwise, it looks rather good. They've done a wonderful job here in terms of putting together getting the elevation up with the sandbags. It's just that one area that I saw that looked like it could be trouble. It's 12:30 in the afternoon on a beautiful sunny March day. Everybody's feeling very spring-like and we're ready to take our jackets off, but we need to make sure that this flood passes with a minimal amount of damage.
Hello, I'm Mayor Joe McDonald, and we're right now standing on the corner of bridge and river. As you can see behind us, the Crow River is rising. Today is the 20th of March, approximately 2:20. We're expecting the river to crest at approximately 7 o'clock tonight or so, according to the National Weather Forecast, and it's expected to crest at 20.5. So the city has been working hard the last 2, 3, 4 days preparing for this flood. And I just want to mention that our city crew, our city administrator Phil Kern, our city engineer Vince Vandertop, Bob Van Lith, our fireman, our fire chief, Ernie Eden, the public works director, Tim Schrupp, and there's almost too many to really share at this point. Luke Fisher, another one, have worked very hard in preparing and implementing this phase one and phase two of flood mitigation. So I want to commend them on their great work. Their quick reaction, and it's been working really well. I mean, if there was a machine, it's to liken it to a well-oiled machine. And they really deserve the praise and the thanks because they've worked very hard. They're keeping the council, myself, informed at all times with updates and what's happening. And so it's just working flawlessly. As far as volunteers goes, let me just mention that the city of Delano's residents and businessmen and women and people just came together to help out sandbag and do what they can to help save the town and save the downtown area. And the outpouring of thanks and that they're thinking of us and their help and their volunteers has been tremendous. Towns such as Rockford and Buffalo and Watertown and Maple Plain and have been great in helping out and assisting us with personnel and manpower and equipment, and our great thanks goes out to those cities as well. The people of Delano have been outstanding, as I said, coming and volunteering at all hours of the day, 24/7, to help prepare for this cresting of 20.5. So we're in good shape at this point. We're kind of out of the water, if you forgive the pun, but we got it under control and we're doing well so far. So, you know, downtown is active. We've had people throughout all day and night looking at the river, coming in from all parts of the state. Right now, the bridge behind us here on Bridge Avenue is closed. Our city engineer, Vince Vandertop, thought perhaps it might be best to close it off just because of the pressure and the vehicles on it and the weight. We just thought better safe than sorry. Yesterday they completed a temporary dike extending 2 blocks to the south here at Day's Town Club and all the way down to the Granite Works building and to hold back the water. Fortunately, it's not up to that point yet, so we're continuing to monitor that as well. There are certain areas of the dike that there are some leakage, and our city crews and staff, Public Works, are working hard and monitoring those, ensuring that we don't have a disaster at that point. So just we're doing our best and keeping above water, and we're all working well together. It's brought the community together very well. It's not surprising. I've been in town 21 years now, and anytime there's a need, the people of Delano come out to assist, no matter what the case may be, no matter what the hour, they're here to lend a hand. The outpourings of phone calls and email messages and everything else for people wishing us well and offering their help has been tremendous. So thank you to the staff, the crew, and those of you who are watching this in the future, we hope that you won't have to endure this flood. But if you do, if you follow the good advice and the good works that we implemented here at the city, you'll be in good shape.